welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Stephanie, and I appreciate y'all stopping by. Today's video will be a little bit different than usual. I have a haul here from Temu, and I want to share that with y'all first. Then I'm going to show y'all how I use several of these items to create 6 easy and gorgeous farmhouse decor pieces. I hope y'all enjoy the video, and if you do, please give it a thumbs up, and be sure to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. Let's jump into the haul. First up in the haul are these 6 red long stem roses. These are beautiful and really high quality at a very reasonable price. I also ordered 6 of these cream colored long stem roses as well. Next, I got one of these hanging Boston ferns. Again, great quality, great price. I also got these floral picks in orange and yellow, a light purple, a dark purple, one in white, and the last one in yellow and pink. I also grabbed a 12-piece of the eucalyptus stems. I got one of each of the many fake potted plants that are rosemary, spring grass, and yew. I also picked up some tools, starting with this 11-piece set of mini circular saw blades that's going to be perfect for my Dremel. I got 2 of these simple press knife pins for cutting paper, a set of 5 magnetized screwdriver bits for a drill. Next up, I got a 4-piece set of these fruit spoons, and they are absolutely adorable, and I have a few projects for these, so stay on the lookout. One of these bee beaded ornaments and one of the buzz off bee ornaments, a set of these honeybee solar lights, one of these wood beaded garlands with tassels, because you really can't have enough of those. I also got one of these pet footprint kits that I'm really excited to use. I couldn't pass up these adorable stork shaped embroidery scissors. And I needed a new pair of detail scissors, so I went ahead and picked up this pair of vintage stainless steel scissors. I picked up some of this gold leaf, a 3-pack of these 1.5-inch nylon brushes, and of course I had to pick up a 3-pack of the 2-inch nylon brushes as well. I thought this little engraved tool looked really neat, so I decided to give it a try. I also went ahead and ordered one of these continuous spray bottles. I thought this coffee wall decal set would be perfect to spruce up my coffee bar. I absolutely fell in love with this vintage farm poster with the cow, pig, and chicken stack, so I knew I had to get that. This is another item I just had to have, this iron silhouette of a cow, donkey, and duck. And y'all, I know that y'all know that I love Highland cows, so I had to have this adorable Highland cow canvas poster. I picked up this 3-piece All of Me Loves All of You wall set to DIY into some bedroom decor. I thought this Today I Choose Joy canvas poster was too cute to pass up, and I knew what I was going to do with it. And last but not least, again with my obsession with Highland cows, I picked up this adorable plush Highland cow that I absolutely love. Right now, Temu is running a massive site-wide sale for spring, so if you want to get your hands on any of these items and so much more, be sure to head over to Temu.com or download the Temu app for discounts on up to 90% off. Temu offers free shipping and free returns for up to 90 days and accepts all major credit and debit cards, electronic payments, and even pay later programs. Find the link below for the items featured in this video and use the code CAT7879 for 30% off your order. All right, let's go ahead and jump into DIY number 1. For this project, I used these 3 mini potted plants from Temu. I painted all 3 pots with plaster colored chalk paint. Once the paint was dry, I used hot glue to attach some jute cord around the bottom half of the pot. I did use glue all the way around the first time, then just added the glue as needed until I had the pot wrapped about halfway. I then cut off the excess twine on the back side of the pot and secured the end in place with hot glue. Once I had the pot wrapped, I took some scissors and trimmed up the fuzzies off the jute. I then repeated this step to cover the bottom halves of the other 2 pots. Next, I used a wooden hanging wall shelf and 4 mini wooden flower pots. I used hot glue to attach one of the flower pots upside down on each of the holes on the bottom of the hanging shelf to create the feet for the tray. When I had all the flower pots in place, I stained the entire tray with some weathered gray stain. Once the stain was dry, I used a coarse stencil brush and some plaster colored chalk paint and heavily dry brushed the top and bottom of the tray. I also used some ink-colored chalk paint to paint the wooden flower pots. Next, I took 2 of these handles and removed the screw from each end. I used hot glue to attach them to the top of the tray on each end, placing the two ends of the handles over the holes on the top of the tray. Of course, these are just for decor purposes, but if you want a stronger and longer lasting hold, you could use a stronger adhesive. Then to finish up this quick little project, I placed the three mini potted plants on the top of the tray, and that's it. I love how this one turned out, and the quality of the plants in these mini pots are amazing. They definitely look like they cost a whole lot more than they actually did. Moving right along to DIY number two. For this project, I used this gorgeous vintage farm canvas poster and one of these wood palette signs. I started by using a heat tool to help loosen up the glue holding the clothespins onto the sign so that I could easily pop them off. Once I had the clothespins off the sign, I took a sanding sponge and sanded the entire front of the sign so that it was nice and smooth. Next, I stained the palette part of the sign with some weathered gray stain, leaving the frame natural wood. Once the stain was dry, I used plaster-colored chalk paint and painted the frame. I had to cut down the poster just a tad so that it would fit in the frame of the sign, so I used a rotary cutter and cut a little of the canvas off of each side of the poster. I then used hot glue along just the edges of the poster to adhere it to the middle of the sign. The hot glue will show through the canvas material, so you definitely want to keep it along the outside edges of the poster. Once I had the poster adhered to the sign, I took some nautical rope and used hot glue to attach it around the poster on the inside of the frame to help cover up the edges where the poster was a little short on the top and bottom. I did have to use the tip of some scissors to get the rope into the corners of the frame. I continued to attach the rope to the sign until I got back to the top corner and cut off the excess rope and used hot glue to secure it in place. Then to finish up this project, I took four of these large decorative brass tacks and placed one in each of the four corners and hammered them into place to help cover up the gaps between the rope in the corners of the frame and to give this piece a nice finished look. I absolutely love this wall piece and it is hands down my favorite project from today's video. On to DIY number three. For this project, I used this Highland Cow canvas poster and this large bamboo cutting board. I applied an even thick layer of decoupage glue to the front of the cutting board and used a foam brush to evenly spread it, paying close attention to the edges and that they were completely covered. Once I had the adhesive on the cutting board, I centered the poster in the middle and smoothed out all the bubbles and wrinkles and set it aside to dry for a couple of hours. After the piece was completely dry, I flipped it over and took some detailed scissors and cut off all the excess canvas that was hanging over the edge. Next, I took some hot glue and attached some nautical rope around the edges of the poster to give it a nice finished look. I also want to mention I did go ahead and burn off all the twine fuzzies from the rope before putting it on the canvas to give it a more rustic look. I did leave the sides of the cutting board free of the rope so that it would have a little more texture. Once the rope was in place, I flipped the piece over and took two large sawtooth picture hangers and placed them on the top corners of the back side of the piece so that it could be hung up securely since this piece is a bit heavy due to the cutting board. Then to finish up this quick little project, I took one of the carnation type flowers off this white pick from Temu and one of the orange and yellow flowers off this other pick from Temu and used a generous amount of hot glue to attach the white flower to the poster right on top of the white carnation. I then added hot glue to the back of the orange and yellow flower and placed it on top of the pink carnation. Once the glue had set up, I stood the piece up and applied more hot glue over the stems on the florals for some added security, and this one is done. I think this wall decor piece turned out so cute. I've always loved these prints, and I think the rope and 3D flowers really bring it to life. All right, moving on to DIY number four. For this next project, I used this iron silhouette of a cow, donkey, and duck, and this 11 by 11 inch wood plaque. I started by removing both hangers from the back side of the plaque. I then painted the plaque with one very light coat of plaster colored chalk paint. Once the paint was dry, I turned the plaque sideways and applied some E6000 glue along the edge of the iron silhouette and placed it on the plaque, getting the edges of the silhouette flush with what is now the side of the plaque, and set it aside to dry for several hours. Next, I painted 3 furniture tags with ink-colored chalk paint, sticking them into some foam board to make them easier to paint. After all the paint was dry, I placed 1 of the tacks in each of the holes on the side of the silhouette and hammered them into place for some added security and to cover up the holes. You could leave it like this or put some words on the plaque, but I decided to use 4 of these eucalyptus stems from Temu. I used some hot glue and jute cord to wrap the stems of the eucalyptus together a little ways down to help secure them in place and to dress them up a bit. Once I was happy with the amount of wrapping on the stems, I cut off the excess jute cord and secured it in place with hot glue. I then took some wire cutters and cut off the excess stems. Next, I used a generous amount of hot glue to attach the eucalyptus stems to the left side of the plaque and held them in place until the glue set up. Then, to finish up this project, I made a simple bow with some more of the jute cord and hot glued it to the eucalyptus stems and cut off the tails. I also added 1 of the hangers back onto the back of the plaque so that this piece could be hung up, and this one is finished. This one is a close second to my favorite today. I love how simple it is, and the iron silhouette is absolutely beautiful. Let's move on to DIY number 5. For this project, I used this Today I Choose Joy canvas poster and some foam board. I started by stretching out the poster on the foam board and marking where I needed to cut the board so that the canvas print was just a bit larger than the piece of board, and cut it to size using a sharp utility knife. Once I had the foam board cut to size, I placed the canvas in the center of the foam board and used hot glue to secure the edges of the canvas around the edges of the foam board. I would highly recommend using finger protectors or some other instrument to hold the canvas in place on the hot glue while it sets up, since this canvas does get pretty hot. I continued to wrap the canvas around the foam board, pulling it tight until I had it fully adhered. I wanted to show that on the edges I folded them up like I would if I were wrapping a present to have a nice finished look. I felt like this piece needed a little something extra, so I took some jute cord and used hot glue to adhere it around the outside edge of the canvas to cover up the seams and to give a nice finished look. Then, to finish up this quick little project, I took 3 tumbling tower blocks and used hot glue to attach them to the bottom backside of the canvas, placing 1 on each corner and then 1 in the middle. The canvas still needed a bit more support to stand on its own, so I took 3 more blocks and glued them to the 3 blocks I already had in place on the back of the canvas, and this one is done. I think this one turned out cute, and it looks really nice on my curio cabinet with my chicken wire cloches. And last but not least, DIY number 6. For this quick little project, I used this 3-piece set of canvas art and some 5-gallon paint stir sticks. I started by laying 1 of the canvas prints flat on the table and then laid out 4 of the paint stir sticks onto the canvas, marking where they needed to be cut so that they would frame the print. Once I had all the stir sticks marked, I took them outside and cut them to size. I then used hot glue to attach the stir sticks around the sides of the canvas. I started by attaching the top and bottom pieces of the frame and then the 2 side pieces. After I had the frame glued into place on the canvas, I did go back and add some hot glue on the ends of the side pieces and attach the side pieces to the top and bottom pieces. Then I flipped the canvas over and cut off all the excess canvas that was hanging over the sides of the frame. I then repeated these steps to frame the other 2 canvas prints. Once I had all the canvases framed, I used a stencil brush and plaster-colored chalk paint and heavily dry-brushed over the frames. To finish up this quick little project, I added a jute hanger to the back of each of the prints, and that's it for this one. I love how these turned out, and I can't wait to hang them over the bed in the master bedroom. Here is the final reveal of all of today's farmhouse decor using items from Temu. I absolutely love how all these projects turned out and cannot wait to add them to the rest of my everyday farmhouse decor in my home. Which one of these projects is your favorite? Let me know in the comments below. I absolutely love the vintage farm sign. Don't forget to go check out Temu.com or the Temu app and get some of these amazing products that are high quality at a great price. Also, don't forget to use the code CAT7879 for 30% off your order. The links will be in the description box below. I want to thank each and every one of you for stopping by, and if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. It really does help me out here on YouTube, and if you haven't hit that subscribe button yet, what are you waiting for? Click that button and stick around for a little while. I have tons of fun projects on the way. I'll see y'all next time.